Very good afternoon. I'm Dr. Sakshi Dharikar and working as a faculty member at Center for Applied Research in Electronics at IIT Delhi, which is the capital city of India. And I would like to thank IEEE Sensors for giving an opportunity to come here and present our work. So my talk includes, it's an interdisciplinary topic. As you can see, it talks about materials and then some bio, which is like bacteria, and then photoluminescence is like complete device characterization, material characterization. So I will start with a basic introduction, first the outline, which says which are the topics that I'll be covering, like bacteria sensing, why it's important, why we are using heterostructures, how we fabricate the device, how we characterize, what are the results, the key results that we have found till now, and then it's concluded. So coming on to bacteria sensing and why it is important. So I think there would hardly be anyone who would not know about why bacteria sensing is important. It's in the media, in the news, every year across the globe, many people fall sick or even die because the water that they're intaking is contaminated. So the idea is to have a device which you can use again and again. If you cannot use it again and again, maybe it's very cheap, so you can, it's a disposable kind of thing, and you can use the other chip into your reader, which tells you how much bacteria is present in the water. So it has to be field deployable. That's the first thing. And it should be produced in large numbers. So we need mass production. And so here we relate health to technology. We have health aspects, people are falling sick and dying, and we need a technology which can help the common man. So people have made several efforts. It's not just us who are working. Many people have been working in this area. So this is one of the kits which came in the news that was developed by one of the team in Canada, where they do some kind of testing at the field and they do some chemical reactions and check if the water is contaminated or not. So coming on to our work. So why do we use heterostructures? Why cannot we just have one layer of film and then see the properties and decide if it is sensing or not? So the idea of using two semiconductors of different band gaps is that we can play around with the interface. So this interface, which is like a depletion region, it becomes very sensitive. And we are checking it through photoluminescence studies. We are checking the behavior of this interface through photoluminescence studies to check if bacteria is being sensed or not. And the most important feature of our work is the, so we work on chip fabrication. So whatever processes we use are scalable and reproducible. If I talk about sputtering or I talk about thermal evaporation, lithography, these are the techniques that you can use for scaling up your number of devices. So how do we fabricate the sensor? So it's a very simple process. We start with silicon wafer and on the back side we do aluminium deposition so that we can take it for electrochemical process. So we need the current to flow. We deposit aluminium as the backside contact and then we take it through electrochemical etching, which makes it porous silicon. So we have on top of the layer almost 5 micron, on top of the substrate almost 5 micron of layer, which is in a porous network. On this we deposit TiO2 of 10 nanometer and then we anneal it for making it more sensitive phase, which is called as the anatase phase. So to compare if this heterostructure is the one that we are looking for or not, we also need to compare it with the basic substrates. So we check it in the end, we make TiO2 on porous silicon and we check it with simple porous silicon and then TiO2 with just crystalline silicon on top, so no porous silicon in between, and we see their behaviors. So after we fabricate, yes, for bio purpose, we have to functionalize the surface. So what do? We clean the surface, wash it with water and ethanol, and this is the OH terminate surface that we get. Then we treat it with APTES and intolerant for 24 hours. What we get in the end is amine terminated group. Now this device is taken to two processes. First process is where we further expose it to glutaraldehyde and then expose it to the antibody. So what we are doing in this process, we are attaching a linker in between, where now we have carboxyl groups on the top, which will now combine to antibody. Antibodies already have amine groups. So this reaction of antibody to this carboxyl is a definite reaction. Why we are losing on this part is that we are adding one more layer on top, and so the device, the material property is not very significant in this case. That is why adding glutaraldehyde was not much taken forward in our work. And in the second process, what we do, we leave it as such at the APTS step and introduce it to the antibody. Now, whatever carboxyl group is there in the antibody, which is a limitation of the work, yes, but in this case, whatever sensing is happening is because of the substrate. That is what we want. If only the layer, like here is glutaraldehyde, will be dominant, then there is no point having this kind of a substrate. You can just do it with a glass slide or a crystalline silicon surface. But we know that the substrate is more sensitive, and we want to study its properties because we are trying to do batch fabrication for particular kind of device. So we want the material to respond, not the layer to respond. Therefore, we go with process 2, where we do ABTS and then we introduce it to antibody and then the antigens. And now coming on to material characterization, this is the SEM analysis. So here on top we see this is mainly TiO2 on porous silicon. So the underneath layer is porous silicon, which is here, which is almost 120 nanometer of pores. And here we can see these tracks are formed between the TiO2 material, which are almost 50 nanometer wide. If you see the cross-sectional of the device, so here we see porous silicon is quite big, it's almost 5 micron, whereas TiO2 is what we deposited was almost 10 nanometer. Through Raman and XRD, we can conclude that yes, we can see TiO2, and through XRD also we get to see a peak at 25.4, which shows 101 phase of TiO2. And so PL studies here, we see that porous silicon shows one peak at around 700, which happens because of the photo absorption that takes place near the edge of the conduction band. And in case of a composite material, or I should say a hybrid or a heterostructure material, we see TiO2 porous silicon bearing two peaks, with main peak as a 765, which is present because of the oxide defects that are present because of TiO2 now on the surface. So these are the XPS studies which were done to understand what kind of bond energies are present on the surface. Like here we can see in case of nitrogen, which is, I should say, as prepared was very less, but if you see when the sample was treated with APTS, it increased because of the amine group now present on the surface. And oxygen certainly showed a shift with some kind of decrease, because a lot of oxygen vacancies which are present on the surface are now covered with APTS. So that is why there's a big shift and it quenches slightly. In TI, we could not see much difference, probably because of the penetration. We could not go to that level and see a good signal for TI. And this is another XPS study where both APTS and glutaraldehyde were used. We don't see much change here, whereas we see a big change here. Now, because glutaraldehyde, as the structure says, there is no amine group present, your nitrogen has almost gone down. So this is to understand the surface so that the reactions could be well understood. So to conclude the functionalization part, we decided to not go with the process one, because here glutaraldehyde was dominant. And another thing that we observed in process one was when we took PL, so we did PL measurements for this sample and this sample, here the photoluminescence was enhanced multiple times only because of the presence of glutaraldehyde. Before that, it was only the surface which was showing an effect. So process 2 was taken forward and process 1 was not taken forward. Now, coming on to the results. So, if I see borosilicate, and this is just the one that was prepared, this is the one that was APTS and glutaraldehyde functionalized, and then we attach the antibody. We can see there is a small blue shift and enhancement. So why this could be happening? Because silicon by nature gets oxidized the moment it is out in the air. So all these oxygen bonds, they are negatively charged, and they form like a sphere around the silicon, because of which the oxygen ring gets expanded and the silicon nanocrystallite effectively reduces, because of which we see a blue shift and enhancement in the PL intensity. Now, in this case where we have both TiO2 and borosilicate, we can see that as prepared is the red curve, and the green one is slightly quenched, which is in presence of APTS, and there is a blue shift. This could be because here, in case of again TiO2 PS, we have a lot of oxygen on the surface, and when APTS binds, these oxygen vacancies come down. That is how the PL slightly quenches, and upon addition of these antibodies, they are back again on the surface. That is how they go back again. Now, from the same studies, we could see the bacteria getting attached. This was E. coli bacteria, but this is a non-pathogenic strain. This is not a pathogenic strain. So this is getting attached onto the surface. So this is for one specific concentration, like 10 power 2 CFU per ml. If I increase it to 10 power 6 or 10 power 8, then the number of bacteria, the density of bacteria increases. Now, coming on to the sensing in presence of various concentration of antigens. The antigen that we used was JCM109. And here it shows that this is only functionalized. And as we are going up, we see that the concentration of bacteria is increasing. So we checked it from 1 to 8. And if I translate this graph to this here, this shows sensor response percent versus concentration. So sensor response percent is calculated by knowing the reference value of the intensity and knowing the value of intensity after exposure to bacteria. And we see it gives a good response, and even after seeing the error bar, this is quite 10 power 1 and 10 power 2 are quite differentiable. And now this one shows in case of borosilicate, which is certainly very less, and this is only in presence of TiO2, no borosilicate introduced. I think this is very less because of TiO2 being of very less thickness. It's only 10 nanometer. And here it's with borosilicate 10 nanometer. So we can see a big change in intensity and response in case of a heterostructure. Now, this is just the summary to show that this is silicon. So main difference between porous silicon and a heterostructure would be the number of sites. When I'm introducing a metal oxide on top of a porous substrate, while it is being fabricated on the surface, it is giving a lot of surface area to volume ratio, and in addition to that, a lot of oxygen sites. If we have more oxygen sites, we have better binding with the functionalization step or the antibody introduction step in our work. So that is why this surface is meant to be more sensitive than the single layer counterpart. So to conclude, we prepared samples with different substrates, borosilicate, TiO2 and a heterostructure. Functionalization was done using both APTS and glutaraldehyde, whereas it was observed that the functionalization step of just APTS was sufficient to give a good signal for photoluminescence, and PL was enhanced upon attachment of antibody and antigen, and even detection of 10 power 1 could be detected using this process. This enhancement was thought to be seen because of increasing defects or due to the nucleophilic reaction that is taking place on the surface. These are the references. This is our team. So this work is done with our collaborator in Toyo University, Japan. And these are my colleagues and some students in IIT. This is the Toyo team. We acknowledge Government of India for funding this project. And Thank you for your attention, and if there are any questions.